What it do, YouTube? My name is Bear Witness. Welcome back to the channel. Now, in today's video, we're going to be talking about the Division 2, but more specifically, we're going to be talking about Endgame. So if you guys haven't gotten to Endgame yet, then I hope you guys still enjoy this video, but this video is probably not for you. But a friendly reminder, if you guys are new to the channel, make sure you guys are clicking that like button, that sub button, and that bell to be notified on every single one of my future uploads so you guys can be notified on all of that stuff. But with all that being said, guys, let's hop right into it. So I've been at Endgame for, I'd say, about 2 days now. I've pretty much done at most of, if not everything that I can do. You know, I've still got to go around and get the airdrops. I've still got, I have to get a couple of the masks. So there is still quite a bit for me to do. But I have noticed that as of hitting level 450, aside from recalibrating your gear to get to 460, there's not very much for you to do at the current moment. And I realize that a lot of looter shooters are kind of like this, especially in the first coming months and with regular updates in the future. I really feel like they'll fix this problem, but I wanted to go ahead and address it, hit the nail on the head, and really talk about it for anybody that was in the same boat as me and kind of wondering what you're supposed to do. Right now, I found the most fun thing for me to do is kind of help out people, getting them to level up, helping them find gear and stuff like that, and explaining how they can have a really good build. But aside from that, guys, there's not actually much to do, and that's because the loot in this game is actually, as much of it that we get is actually pretty terrible. And I'm not gonna say that the loot is terrible and the idea of, oh, you know, there's not enough of it. It's more terrible that we get the same things. There's only a set amount of things that you can get, and we get the same things over and over again. Now, yeah, there's different versions of the items, but ultimately, the pool of items that we could potentially get as high ends is actually pretty small. Go ahead, and if you guys have been playing for a while, go ahead and look in your own inventory right now and see how many duplicates of weapons that you actually have. On a regular time, I say I would get at least, you know, I'd say 5, 6, you know, or more duplicates in a session. And because of that, we're not really getting anything different. We're getting the same loot. There's no incentives to play any of the activities in this game. Multiplayer, there's no specific weapons that are going to drop from that. There's no specific gear sets that are built for PvP. And that's somewhat, now I wouldn't say frustrating, but that's somewhat, you know, not, I'm trying to figure out the words because I'm really not trying to bash the game. And so that's where I'm trying to tiptoe around my words. But I wish there were PvP sets that we could actually use inside the Dark Zone and inside actual PvP. There's also no solo sets for anybody, and I know that those kind of those gear sets came as of like at a later time inside of the Division 1, but there's nothing for solo players. There's nothing for PvP players. Like, though there are PvP builds that you can actively make more appropriate for PvP, I'm talking about like PvP specific builds and things like that. There's no exotics that necessarily drop for the associated activities. Like, you can do challenge modes and dailies all you want to, but there's really no reason to after you get them done the first time, because the equipment that you're getting is usually the same equipment. Now, granted, there are you know, some exotics, and there's possibly some exotics that we haven't found yet just because they're that rare. But right now, I'm pretty sure the Ruthless exotic is the only one that I know that you don't have to craft, and it just drops from a mission. But aside from that, aside from just grinding that mission, there's only, from what I know, 4 exotics in this game. The Deagle, there's the Ruthless Assault Rifle or Marksman Rifle, there's the Chatterbox SMG, and there is also the exotic shotgun that you can't really level right now because the other variant of the shotgun isn't in the game as my knowledge. So there's no real incentive to play any of the activities at the current moment. Now, I'm really hoping that in the next coming update, the one that releases Tidal Basin, that they add a couple of things and add a couple of fixes. Obviously, they'll be adding in World Tier 5, so there might be some cool stuff that we're able to only get if we're in World Tier 5. But currently, guys, I'm just curious on your thoughts about the end game of the Division 2. Are you guys still in the honeymoon stage and just enjoying the game? Are you guys late game grinders or in game grinders that are just like bored at this point because you really don't have much to do or anything like that, guys? So make sure you guys leave that in the comment section down below. Once again, if you guys did like the video, make sure you guys leave a like down below, as well as clicking that sub button and that bell to be notified on every single one of my uploads. And with all of that being said, I hope you guys have a nice, wonderful rest of your day, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.